Hi friends, welcome to Aishudiy. Today we will see a simple earring with this 10 by 8 millimeter, I guess, 10 or 8 by 6 millimeter. Let me see what size this is. So I guess it's definitely not 6 by 4. That much I'm positive of. But let's just find out what the size of this bead is. So this is something that we use to find the size of our beads. So there we go. This is 10 millimeter and by 6 millimeter, 10 by 6 millimeter or 8 millimeter. It is 10 by 6. Yes, 10 by 6 millimeter. Okay, and then this is 6 by 4, I guess, and. So, and then we need some 24 gauge wire. I'm using bead landing. This is from Michaels. And tools wise, we need our nylon jaw pliers, our needle nose pliers, wire cutters, and round nose pliers. These are the things we are gonna need. We will need ear wires, that's for sure. You can either use the ear wire, the store-bought ear wire, which I'm gonna use right now, or you can make your own with 20 gauge wire. I have uploaded several videos for a decorated ear wire and the ear wires that is very simple. So you can go ahead and watch it from my channel. And now let's get started. So for the beginning, I just want some gauges missing over here. So I want to just take about 6 to 8 inches of wire. Just cut about 6 to 8 inches of wire. And we shall measure so that we will cut the same for the next one too. So take our ruler and measure this about 7 inches, guys. Okay. And then what we are going to do is we are going to put the bead, the bigger bead, in almost the middle of the wire and then bend this. Just like that. Insert one end of the wire again inside the bead one more time and then pull it with the other, pull it by the other end. If you're not able to pull with your hands, gently use your pliers to pull the wire. Might be a little bit tough, but we can get it through. So basically I want the wire to hug the bead. So it looks like that. Then take the other piece of the wire and put it through the other end and then gently pull with your needle nose or tweezer nose pliers and just make sure you pull both ends carefully, and then you can use your nylon jaw pliers to kind of squish it, because that way you won't spoil the wire. So now we have 3 wraps in full. The first one is the one which is not going properly, I guess, but that does not the matter. This place looks awesome, the front. And There we go. Now we have our wires crossed on the top. I would just do this and make it straight in the center. And then what I can do is I can add a roundel, 6 by 4 millimeter roundel, and make sure both the wires go through that bead and just make it all the way here. Doesn't look very good, so let's just wrap this and okay, then add this bead, snip this off excess wire first, and then we can tuck in the tail too. Okay, now we have this. Now put your round nose pliers on top. I want this to be protruding, then only it will look nice. And then do this a small wrapped loop. And then snip this wire. Tuck in the tail. And then open up your ear wire. And whichever side looks good, so there we go. Adjust the loop if need be. That's a cute earring. So we don't need 7 inches per se, we can just take 6 inches of wire. That should be good enough for our project. And then I saw this earring without the top bead on Pinterest and I really kind of liked it, so I thought that why not we do it. So you just insert it to the center of your wire and then cross it and bring it back into the same hole. Just make sure that this one is also crossed, otherwise you will lose the center spot. So you go through this bead and gently try to pull it with your hands, or you can use your pliers to do that for you. And just make sure it's nice and tight. You can use your nylon jaw pliers. And then you can just tighten it like this. And then take the other end and then put it back into the same hole. And then pull it with your pliers. There we go. And now we have this. Then we take it up and wrap one wire on top of the other and make a wrapped loop. And snip off the excess wire. Tuck in the small tail, and this is what we have now. Just make sure all the wraps are consistent with each other, and whichever side looks good, now we can add our 6x4mm roundel. You can use a contrast color too. I'm using the same color, but you can use a contrast color too, and that will look different and pretty as well. Or you can even use a bicone or a gemstone bead, whichever you want. Because we are not passing through this top bead several times, which we were doing with the bottom bead. So we don't need a bigger hole. Gemstone can very well be used for that. Okay. Now all we need to do is take our ear wire, open our ear wire, and then add this to the ear wire. Our earrings are ready, nice and done to be worn. And this is really, really pretty. If you guys like this video, subscribe to my channel, give it a thumbs up, and hit the bell icon for notification. And this is our earring that we made for today. I hope you guys like this. Leave some comments below. I would love to hear from you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day. Bye.